This is WBVT News, Black Voices Television. Here are your anchors, John Galloway and Ebony Johnson.
Hello, I'm Ebony Johnson.
And I'm John Galloway. These stories highlight our news this evening. Life after the Rodney King verdict. Gangs and how they affect East Liberty cleanup efforts. And the effect of the maglev super train on the African-American community.
But first, our top story. More than 200 people gathered outside the Board of Education in Oakland during a three-day prayer vigil in support of Dr. Loretta C. Webb. Dr. Webb is the only African-American candidate for superintendent for the Pittsburgh Public Schools. Mark Brentley, one of the event's organizers, calls Dr. Webb an advocate for education who could improve the system for all races.
I mean, if you just look at the crowd behind me alone, we're talking young, old, elected official, community activists, white, Muslims, Jewish members. There's a broad range of folks who support this movement.
According to District 8 school representative John Suver, the prayer vigil show that people are in support of change.
We're saying we don't want the politics as usual. That happens in politics here. We want to see someone who's going to be a catalyst for change. And I think that's what's going to make the difference. Either they're going to be change or we're going to be some of the same things we've been doing. It's going to be cold soup warmed over again.
I also talked with board member Valerie McDonald, who says the prayer vigils are a challenge to board members to listen to the constituents, the parents, and students, and vote accordingly. A decision is expected tomorrow.
Danielle Smith is standing by with a report on police brutality. Danielle?
Thank you, John. On March 3, 1991, the world watched in despair as four white police officers brutally beat motorist Rodney King. Many blacks watched with tears, fearing it could have been themselves, but in the eyes of others, he was thought of as just another black person being beaten by the police. An unofficial poll was taken by this reporter. Some say police brutality is a problem in the black community and that it is part of their everyday life. On the other hand, people told me that all police aren't bad. Because of the few who are, most get the bad rap.
I'm not aware of any police brutality as such occurring in Pittsburgh. However, we will be working with all of those groups to address not only the crime problem, but any future problems that may arise from the community and the police department.
The measures police take to protect the citizens is that they respond to calls and take the actions depending on the incident at hand. They are here to serve the citizens of America and not to harm them. John?
Thank you, Danielle.
In East Liberty, gangs gang up while local teens try to clean up. Zakiya Redd is standing by with the story. Zakiya?
Thank you, Ebony. East Liberty kids trying to beautify their Lorimer Avenue neighborhood are being harassed by local teenagers. These teens are related to the Lorimer Avenue gang, also known as the LA Hoods. A few weeks ago, the harassment was targeted to the founder and president of East Liberty Concerned Citizens Corporation, Aura Lee Carroll. Several days ago, her house was vandalized. Graffiti on the wall said, LA Crips 135. This message threatens murder. Last night, her house was burned down. She lost all of her belongings, including her dog. Fortunately, no one was killed. Police suspect arson, and she does also.
A nightmare began when they began to threaten and go to my job site and threaten my supervisor, threaten and break out windows at my center, not torching my home.
I spoke with a few of the kids in Ms. Aura Lee Carroll's program. They told me that there were kids involved in the LA gang that Ms. Aura Lee Carroll tried to reach out to, but apparently couldn't. They were kicked out of the program, which is when the harassment began. Ms. Carroll says that she won't back down. God has kept her strong, and this has made her stronger. She is going to continue the program, which she initially started with her own money. Her ultimate goal is to have the youth center stay open for 24 hours a day, and that any youth with the right conduct could join. Ebony?
Thank you, Zakiya. John?
Maglev may bring a cutting-edge technology to Pittsburgh with a rail system that looks like something out of the movie Star Trek. Although it looks complex, the principle is very easy. Unlike conventional railroad cars, Maglev doesn't ride on rails. It uses a cushion of air created by magnets pushing away from each other and allows the train to actually float above the rail, thus giving it the name magnetic levitation. Pittsburgh is a prime candidate for this new technology, especially with $2 million recently committed by the Casey administration for research. The proposed route will run from the new airport to downtown Pittsburgh and possibly to Oakland.
Well, that really moves things along.
The focus of teen parenting is placed on women. Here's a story of teen fathers taking action.
More and more black teen fathers are taking responsibility for the lives they've helped create. According to Anthony Bell, caseworker for Pittsburgh in partnership with parents, out of the teens he's counseled, 50% more black teenage fathers than white are taking responsibility for their children. Randy Smith, a 24-year-old divorced father, is proving this point with his 4-year-old son.
I would like, you know, to have a kid. One of the things I look forward to doing is teaching him about things that I know now that I didn't know when I was his age and as he's coming up and growing up in his life. And if I can give him some pointers and help him out and guide him like my father did, you know, he might become hopefully as successful as I am in one day or, you know, become even more successful.
Smith also says during the school year it's hard, but when summer comes, he can spend more time with his son. And when Christmas comes, Smith says he tries to be like Santa. Back to you, John.
Thank you, Tanya.
John, another progressive group is young African American teens. What you are watching now is the first television broadcast of Teen Talk at local PBS affiliate WQED. Andre Woods has more.
Thank you, Ebony. Pittsburgh's only teen magazine show heard on WAMO radio is broadening their reach to television. Teen Talk is an outgrowth of the radio show with the same name. The program has been produced for about a year and a half. Tanae Kroom, executive producer of the radio show, said that having the show on TV is a great addition to the program. With me here in the studio is one of our show's co-hosts, Dee Tipton.
Hello, Mr. Woods.
Dee, do you think being on TV would make more people tune in?
Yes, I do, because I feel that more people would probably watch the TV show than radio, because more people tend to watch TV than listen to radio.
What is your ultimate goal in having the show put on TV?
My ultimate goal is to go nationwide, because I feel that if we go nationwide, I'll have my face plastered all over, you know, billboards and stuff. But not only that, it's to educate young America. Well, that's our target audience. But not only young America, the older people too, because we want to let them know that African American youth do have something positive to say in society.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
As you can see, Teen Talk has fulfilled its television goal, but now they are reaching for new heights to become a national show expressing the views of African American youths. I'm Andre Woods for WBVT News. Back to you, Ebony.
Thank you for watching, and please tune in again to hear more on our community.
Remember, when news happens and you feel you're only getting one side of it, tune in to WBVT, Black Voices Television.
Good night.
This has been a production of WBVT News, Black Voices Television, the station that's all that and a bag of chips.
Danielle Smith is standing by with a report on police brutality. Danielle.
Thank you, John. On March 3rd,
East Liberty kids trying to beautify their Larimer area neighborhood are becoming harassed. She does also.
Stop.
According to Anthony Bell, casework for...
I'm Andre Woods for WBVT News. Back to you, Ebony.
Okay, nice. Okay, yes.
Oh, one big wonders.
That concludes our program. Please, thank you for watching, and please tune in again for more.
You carry a gun? No, I do not.
that concludes our program. Thank you for watching, and please tune in again to hear more on our community.
Remember, when news happens and you're only getting one side of it, tune in to WBVT, Black News Television.
Good night.
I'm sorry.
This concludes our program. Thank you for watching, and please tune in again to hear more on our community.
Remember, when news happens and you feel you're only getting one side of it, tune in to WBVT, Black Voices Television.
Good night.
You're making me laugh.
Hi, how you doing? And you just got on my nerves the whole production, but you know what? I'm getting paid, so who cares? Yes, that is it. You get it, okay. Hello.
Okay. Kids trying to beautify their Larimer area. East Liberty. Kids trying to.
Very good question, young man. Working to. The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation, working to open the lines of communication. This year, we're celebrating our 10th anniversary, and we'd like to share our pride with you. PBMF is a network of black professionals. Our range of expertise touches all areas of the media. Committed to journalistic excellence, improving communication between the black community and the media, and increasing minority participation in the field. This year, PBMF took a major step towards widening the doors of the communications industry, doors that even the most qualified have difficulty entering. Our first annual journalism workshop, held this spring, gave minority juniors and seniors from area high schools a rare opportunity to explore careers in journalism with professionals in the field. We just
got Pittsburgh Black Media Federation started this education workshop because we know that nationally less than 5% of all journalists are minorities. That includes all types of minorities. We feel it's important now that we have made it, so to speak, to reach back into the community and help some young people along. It's important to us as professionals to see more blacks enter the field, and one way that they can do it is that if we, who are already members of the profession, reach back, teach them, tell them what's important to know as far as preparing for a career and what we had to do to achieve the success that we have had to do. We think that this is very important. We think this is an important program, and it's something that all people in all professions should attempt to do.
For 7 consecutive Saturdays in March and April, workshop participants studied basic news and feature writing, copy editing, reporting, photography, and television production. By the conclusion of the workshop, broadcast students had written, produced, and directed their own television news program. And students in the print section had followed the development of their own student newspaper from the initial gathering of information to its final printing at the Pittsburgh Press. Three students completed the workshop, graduating with a better understanding of the communications field and a sizable head start in the race for success. The development of any professional takes years of training, something PBMF may not be able to constantly provide, but can certainly assist in. The Robert L. Vann Scholarship Award was established in 1982 to provide financial assistance to aspiring young journalists. It's awarded to high school seniors with an expressed interest in journalism and who plan to pursue careers in the media. Last year's winner, Karen Bates, has just completed her freshman year at Wilberforce University in Ohio. This year, we are pleased to be able to award two scholarships. Our first recipient is Mark Dixon of Westinghouse High School, where he graduated eighth in his class. At 18, Mark has already received several literary awards. An essay concerning the late Dr. Martin Luther King earned him a fourth place prize in a countywide competition, followed by a second place award in a high school poetry contest. And his essay entitled The Dred Scott Case was ranked best in the city.
Halfway through my freshman year of high school, I thought that my true desire was to become a professional engineer. However, after being on our newspaper staff for several months, I discovered that I really enjoyed writing and editing. Throughout my high school career, I had taken various writing courses and was on various papers, not only in my high school, but community and church. To get more experience in writing, I entered various contests. Some I won, some I didn't. However, the ones that I won, they really gave me confidence to know that someday I can become a great writer.
This year's second Robert L. Vann Scholarship recipient is 18-year-old Candace Graves of Penn Hills High School. In addition to her strong writing ability, Candace already possesses the ethics of a good reporter. She describes a journalist as one who is directed by truth and integrity and who is dedicated to serving the best interests of the public and the world.
I wanted to become a journalist in ninth grade, and since then have not only taken journalism classes in school, but also entered two journalism workshops, one during my 10th grade year and the other during my senior year. If I were to win the Robert L. Vann Award, it would bring me one step closer to my goal of becoming a Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist.
On the rugged road that leads to prosperity, Candace Graves and Mark Dixon are two young people with promising futures. Through the Robert L. Vann Scholarship, PBMF hopes that we have somehow helped to pave the way.
Thanks, Rowan.
The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation not only strives to encourage qualified students to pursue careers in the media, but we also support professionals in the field. The Robert L. Vann Excellence in Journalism Award commends journalists whose works have spotlighted issues in the black community. This year, we have six winners in the broadcast category, Prison Graves, an investigative report by WTAE-TV's Kathy Milton, focuses on the increasing number of older adults who spent most of their lives behind bars.
It's dangerous to be in here. It's dangerous to be in here. The guys be running and running. They don't be fighting, but they be running. And then some of those guys run over old man and knock him down, he dead.
America's schools home last spring with a failing report
Greg
card.
Greg McCampbell, also from Channel 4, took the Feature News Award for his education update. A report on problems in the educational system. Now Pittsburgh's new prison program is making a difference.
Teacher. As a teacher, I'm now more accountable because I have to think about what I want the student to learn, why I want them to learn it.
And for outstanding public affairs programming, Chris Moore of WQED-TV wins for the 5 C's, a discussion on the controversial issue of academics versus athletics in the public school system.
School is education. Athletics is a secondary part to the educational process. Children should be in school to learn, to prepare themselves for a decent life, to raise children, to fit into the United States, not to bounce balls around.
In the print category, Gene Bryant of the Pittsburgh Press for an investigative report on the obstacles encountered by black business owners in Pittsburgh and across the nation. Gene Collier of the Post-Gazette for his in-depth look at an inner-city dream, breaking out of the ghetto by making it in professional sports. And Clark Thomas, also from the Post-Gazette, for an editorial view of Dr. Jake Malines, president of the Pittsburgh Board of Public Education. In addition to recognizing journalists who have displayed an interest in the black community through their work, PBMF takes great pride in acknowledging the accomplishments of media professionals who reinforce their dedication through active community involvement. This year, we're pleased to present our Outstanding Citizenship Award to Hazel Gollin of the New Pittsburgh Courier for a constant contribution to the city of Pittsburgh. Through the Excellence in Journalism Awards, we hope to encourage journalists to take notice of issues that affect the black community. It's one way of making sure that black news is in the news. Each project that PBMF initiates requires a lot of planning and hard work, but our efforts would be in vain without community backing. We've had a lot of help over the years. Public service organizations, Pittsburgh's corporate community, and the media have all been more than supportive, but it's our responsibility to utilize that assistance in a positive way.
This year, the PBMF has tried to complete three goals. Number one, we wanted to strengthen the inner structure of the organization, make sure that we had operational rules that everyone could follow and understand, and so that people would have a reason to join PBMF. And we've worked very hard to do that. Secondly, the Urban Journalism Workshop, under the direction of Chris Moore and Edwina Rankin, has really been something that we're very proud of. Thirdly, the Journalistic Excellence Awards, under the direction of Meta McMillan, has been expanded to a citywide competition. We're very pleased with the results of that competition, and we hope in future years to come, more of the communications industry will be able to participate. This year has been an exciting one for us, and with the continued support of the corporate community, along with the professionals in the communications industry, we hope to continue to do positive things for Pittsburgh's community.
It's been a good year for PBMF, and we're still working, still growing, working to increase the number of black professionals in the media, working to train our youth, working to make sure black issues get attention. The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation. We're working to open the lines of communication, and our progress is your success.
The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation, striving for excellence in journalism and communications. Pittsburgh Black Media Federation has been in existence for a number of years in the Pittsburgh area. Its primary goal is to bring black members of the media closer together in a professional capacity to enhance, protect, and promote the positions of qualified persons within the industry. It also strives to encourage qualified persons to enter the profession and to stimulate a greater understanding between the media and the black community.
The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation is working very hard to achieve those goals, and I think we're doing a good job. Just the fact that we've come together as a professional organization is helping each one of our members understand the individual problems that we face, and it's helping us grow as a professional organization. We also serve as a conduit between the black community and the news media. At every one of our regular monthly meetings, a black organization, sometimes two, addresses our group about a problem that they're having. We're able, as individuals, to provide better coverage of the black community and more positive coverage. But we're most proud of our workshop. We believe very firmly that you must reach back into the community and help young black people come along.
For 7 weeks in March and April of each year, the PBMF conducts an urban journalism workshop for junior and senior high school students who have displayed an avid interest in journalism and communications.
The workshop consists of three components: print journalism, broadcast journalism, and photography. At the end of 7 weeks, the print students produce a four-page broadsheet newspaper, the broadcast students produce a five-minute television newscast, and photography students have their work shown in the newspaper. I believe that through the workshop, members of PBMF are showing black students that the field of communications is a viable career option for them. In time, our efforts should help to increase the ethnic diversity of newsrooms across the country.
To be able to compete in today's job market, our black youth must seek higher education. The Federation annually offers the Robert L. Vann Scholarships to high school seniors who have been accepted into institutions of higher learning and who have demonstrated an interest in journalism and broadcasting.
Hello, my name is Stephanie Ward, and being considered a candidate for the Robert L. Vann Award is an honor. If I win, I hope to further my education, and I hope the PBMF furthers their goal to help minority students such as myself in careers in journalism.
The Pittsburgh Black Media Federation not only strives to encourage outstanding students to pursue careers in the media, but also recognizes professionals who have given something back to the black community through journalism and communications. The Robert L. Vann Excellence in Journalism and the Outstanding Citizenship Awards commends many of Pittsburgh's finest. With your continuing support, the Pittsburgh Black Media Federation will be able to achieve its goal of excellence in journalism and communications by being the role models for our aspiring youth.